From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. National Security Minister Marvin Dames urged people not to read too deeply into a Royal Bahamas Defense Force memo that directs departments to prepare for a possible early election. The memo, signed by Acting Captain Sean Adderley, was sent in response to a memo from the Parliamentary Registration Department, according to RBDF Commodore Raymond King. While some see it as evidence that Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis is gearing up for an early election, Mr. Dames said this is not necessarily the case. He said, quote, only one person can decide that, and that is the Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Now, we know that these agencies would often prepare earlier than most. That is not out of the ordinary, and so I won't read too deeply into that. This is a normal occurrence. Only one person could determine the date of the election, and he hasn't even done so yet. Acting Parliamentary Commissioner Lavardo Duncanson said yesterday that his department is being as proactive as possible in preparing for the next election, which he said is scheduled on or before May 22, 2022. Fire Services Chief Superintendent Kendrick Morris yesterday defended efforts to fight a massive blaze at Jenny Street on Sunday, insisting water was never an issue. While he admitted that firefighters faced an issue with pressure from a hydrant, he said water was available. On Monday, residents of the area who returned to rummage through the rubble told the Tribune they believed their homes could have been saved. They blamed issues with water for there not being a better outcome. Six homes burned to the ground and four others were damaged in that blaze. Responding, CSP Morris said, quote, with any fire, there are challenges. Like I've said, pressure was a problem coming from the hydrant, but we were getting water. The pressure was not what we would have liked it to be, but water was never an issue. He also was asked about the response time of fire trucks to the scene, to which he responded that the first truck arrived on the scene in 4 minutes from the police headquarters. Tomorrow marks 28 days since the occupants of shanty town structures in the farm in Abaco were told demolition was imminent, and Works Minister Desmond Bannister said officials are ready to do what they have to do. In a joint sting operation last month, residents of the unregulated community received notices from the government advising that the action was to be taken in instances where people inhabited structures in violation of the Building Regulations Act. Mr. Bannister said, quote, we are going into the third phase this week. Thursday makes 28 days. We couldn't go into occupied structures until 28 days had passed, and so we are going into the third phase beginning this week. Our people are mobilized and ready to do what they have to do. The Deputy Prime Minister said he has tried not to speak on the issue publicly in an effort to protect the dignity of those involved. However, he said the law must be enforced. Infectious disease expert Dr. Nakia Forbes said warm water is to blame for the bacteria causing conch poisoning in the country, not the sanitary practices of vendors. The Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries has confirmed at least 10 cases of conch poisoning. Speaking to the Tribune yesterday, Dr. Forbes said, quote, the bacteria that generally causes this usually causes diarrhea illnesses, gastroenteritis, among other things. It is a seafood-related diarrhea illness. What it means is the organism lives in the marine environment usually. It is usually found in the shallow part of the salty water environment. This bacteria increases in the environment as the water temperature increases. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, former President Donald Trump won't return to Facebook, at least not yet. 4 months after Facebook suspended Trump's accounts for inciting violence that led to the deadly January 6th Capitol riot, the company's quasi-independent oversight board upheld the bans. But it told Facebook to specify how long they would last, saying that its indefinite ban on the former president was unreasonable. India's government, facing calls for a strict lockdown to slow a devastating surge in coronavirus infections, was ordered by the Supreme Court today to submit a plan to meet New Delhi Hospital's oxygen needs within a day. The court decided against immediately punishing officials for failing to end a two-week-old erratic supply of oxygen to overstretched hospitals. The court stayed a contempt notice, earlier issued to the government by the New Delhi High Court, for defying its order to supply adequate oxygen to more than 40 New Delhi hospitals. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A high-pressure ridge across the island chain will begin to retreat eastwards through tonight. Beachgoers in the southeast Bahamas should exercise caution due to the risk of rip currents along eastern shorelines. For the northwest and central Bahamas, it'll be variably cloudy and hot, with isolated showers and the slight chance of an isolated thunderstorm in the extreme northwest Bahamas today, turning warm tonight. Winds east-southeast to south-southeast at 10 to 15 knots. northeast, 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. For the southeast Bahamas, it'll be mostly sunny, warm, and breezy, with a few light passing showers today, becoming mostly fair and a bit breezy tonight. A small craft caution is in effect. Winds easterly at 15 to 20 knots today, decreasing 15 knots tonight. Seas 4 to 6 feet over the ocean today, subsiding 3 to 5 feet by tonight. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 88 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 73. The sun will set this afternoon at 7:40 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:31. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.